There are a lot of questions about space and the universe at large. And one of the biggest is, are there Earth-like planets near us? Join us as we show you some recently discovered Earth-like planets in the universe. Number 10. Why do we want to find more Earths? If we're being honest right now, humanity has a pretty sweet deal in regards to the planet that we live on. Currently, Earth is the only known planet that has life on it, to the extent that while it is possible, and even likely, that there is other life out there, we don't know where, or even what it would look like. Earth as a whole is a one-of-a-kind planet, and that's because the kind of planets that it is life-supporting. But while we've been enjoying our run over the course of tens of thousands of years, and millions of years in regards to life in general, there is a fundamental problem that bugs us. Mainly, we know that the Earth won't last forever. What's worse, the Earth right now isn't in the best of shapes. Because of greenhouse gases, the planet is going through global warming, slowly raising the temperature of the Earth, and through that, melting a lot of the ice on the planet. Humanity is going through trees at an incredible rate. We aren't in danger of losing all our oxygen just yet, but it's a legitimate fear. So why are we trying to find more Earths? Because if there is a planet out there that we can call similar enough to our own, it's very unlikely that there is another Earth in terms of an exact copy. We can try and colonize it. Now yes, that would imply that we have the ability to do certain things, including travel through space at an increased rate like Star Wars or Star Trek. But this is most definitely a matter of baby steps. Because we can travel, we should know where we're traveling to, right? Plus, even if we didn't do it for a colonization matter, it's important to know what's out there in space, because humanity likes to dream big, and we want to explore the universe and see if there are other Earths out there, whether in part or in whole. So that's why so many scientists at NASA and other science foundations are trying to figure out this question, and they've had some interesting results so far that gives humanity hope. Number 9. Kepler-438b. In terms of hope, it's unlikely at present that Kepler-438b would be a planet we would reach in the near future, because this planet, discovered in 2015, is actually 470 light-years from Earth. That being said, it might just be the planet we need right now, as it's been deemed one of the most Earth-like planets in the entire universe. How exactly do you measure that? Well, believe it or not, there's an Earth Similarity Index, and Kepler-438b ranks pretty high on it, apparently. In fact, it has an 88% similarity of Earth. That's really high, and so many are hoping to learn about this planet because it could be one that is supporting life right now. Then again, even though it's a 12% difference, that could be all it takes to make it vastly different from Earth as a whole. But we do know that part of the difference is due to its size. Kepler-438b is actually 12% bigger than our Earth, which actually isn't too bad when you think about it. However, some bad things that do need to be pointed out is that it actually gets 40% more light than Earth. Too much light can cause problems for both people, animals, and planets. Oh, and it doesn't exactly have an atmosphere, which is really bad, because that's what keeps all the gases in and helps us breathe. Not to mention the sun around Kepler-438b has some pretty bad solar flares. All in all, that 12% really adds up, huh? Number 8. Kepler-452b. What's with all the Keplers? Okay, that's not really a question, I was just curious after having two of these back to back. The planet was also discovered in 2015, in July to be specific, and upon observing the planet, the people who found it decided to name it Super Earth. And they don't just mean that because it's got superpowers or anything, but rather, Kepler-452b is actually 5 times the size of our Earth. That's massive. But ironically, in terms of the orbit it has around its sun, it's not that far off. It does it in 385 days compared to our 365. That's basically just another month, which wouldn't be too bad. Sadly, the other aspects of Kepler-452b are bad. In space, size really does matter. Our planet is perfect in many aspects in regards to size, and that it includes how big its gravity is. Kepler-452b has gravity twice the size of Earth, and because of its ability to absorb more sunlight via its star. the planet is actually much hotter than our Earth is. Naturally, this would make habitation much harder. Not impossible for the record, but harder. Oh, and there's the fact that this planet is 45,000 light years away, which means light speed travel would be needed in bulk for us to get there. Warp 9, Mr. Crusher, engage. Number 7, the Teegarden Twins. What's that? You want to see some Earth-like planets that are actually closer to Earth in some respects? Okay, science can give you that. Very recently, like found in 2019 recently, observers from Carmens, who are a team looking for Class M planets for us to habitate, found two Earth-like planets just 12.5 light-years from us. Granted, that's still pretty far, but 12 light-years is much closer than 45,000 of the last entry, don't you think? Not to mention, these two planets feel like ones that could have both the necessary water and land for us to live on. The two planets resemble the inner planets of our solar system. Lead author Matthias Zechmeister, a research scientist at the Institute for Astrophysics at the University of Göttingen in Germany, said in a statement, "They're only slightly heavier than Earth and are located in the so-called habitable zone, where water can be present in liquid form." Research has obviously just begun on these two stars, but there is hope that they could be the real deal. For example, usually the fact that this is a red dwarf star called Teegarden would be a red flag, as they don't produce as much heat and light. But the two planets are actually closer to the sun, so that actually could work in our favor. The only true weird thing about these planets is the orbits around their sun. It takes them between 1 to 2 weeks to do it. Even less than that, in fact. That's massively quick. But if you think about it, time is only a construct. So what would really matter is how those quick orbits help or hinder the landscape. Even if those twins aren't perfectly suitable, the team at Carmens are hopeful that other Earth-like planets could be as close as they are, and possibly in the same system as them. Number 6. Kepler-186f. Another Kepler planet. This one was actually the first planet to be defined as Earth-like because it lived in the habitable zone of a star. What does that mean? Well, depending on the planet's position to the star, it can either be too hot to have things like water, or the water on the planet will naturally freeze because of the conditions. Kepler-186f was the first to be noted for having a position in which liquid water could be found. In terms of size, the planet is only about 10% larger than Earth. In contrast, its sun is actually smaller and cooler than our own, which is an interesting mix when you think about it. The orbit it takes is much shorter than our own, only about 130 days. If you're wondering about distance from Earth, Kepler-186f can be found about 500 light-years from Earth and is actually within the constellation known as Cygnus. While scientists are thrilled to find a validated planet within the habitable zone, they also knew that there was still a while to go before finding a true Earth twin. One scientist from NASA noted that it's more like an Earth cousin, which is still progress, and in science, progress is important. Number 5. Barnard Star B. Found in 2018 and located a mere 6 light-years away from Earth, that's really close for the record, Barnard Star B is the second closest exoplanet to Earth right now. But like many planets, there is already some problems being noted by scientists. First off, the mass. The size and mass of Barnard Star B is actually 2.3 times more than Earth, and as noted, that could have a huge impact on the gravity of the planet. Plus, the planet is orbiting a red dwarf star, and its distance ensures that the planet doesn't get a lot of sunlight, which is sad because its orbit of about 233 days is actually really appealing. It's interesting to note that it took them this long to find the planet despite it being so close to Earth and us having found planets much farther away. It actually took a wide array of telescopes and organizations to find it, which does raise an interesting question. If we just found this Earth-like planet in 2018 and it's really close to Earth, are there others out there just waiting to be discovered within the same range? Number 4. Proxima B. Remember when I said that Barnard Star B was the second closest exoplanet to Earth? Well, here's number 1. Proxima B is only 4.2 light-years away from Earth, and it was found in 2016. Like many planets I've noted here, Proxima B orbits a red dwarf star. However, unlike many other planets, this one has been confirmed to not just be in the habitable zone of the star, but also to have the actual presence of water, which is huge in the long term. But sadly, the planet has a ton of downsides, including the fact that its orbit around the Sun is only 11 days. That's a very quick year. And the biggest downfall of all is that the red dwarf star only emits about 2% to the planet, which means the planet on the surface is basically going to be dark all the time. And while there is water, plant life isn't likely to exist. Oh, and as if that wasn't enough, the stellar winds on Proxima B is actually 2,000 times greater than our Earth's. So all in all, it's another swing and a miss, but still a planet to keep an eyeball on. Number 3. Kepler 62f. Oh yeah, another Kepler planet, but also another super-Earth, and was discovered in April of 2013. One of the biggest differences between Kepler 62f and other planets on this list is its star, because the star that the planet orbits is actually 7 billion years old. In terms of star life, that's pretty long. Back to the planet. Kepler 62f is only 1.4 times the size of Earth, which is actually great because gravity wouldn't be that much different and certain features could potentially be the same. Emphasis on potentially. Sadly, while the star of Kepler 62f is old, it doesn't emit the same light and heat, so that actually makes Kepler 62f a bit of a water world. More accurately though, it's one made of ice in many parts. This is due to the fact that Kepler 62f is tidally locked with its star, meaning that one side faces the Sun at all times, while the other doesn't face it at all. Still, scientists believe it could support life, but given the planet's nature, it would likely be localized to certain areas of the world. Number 2. Kepler 22b. Found 600 light-years from Earth, Kepler 22b is within the habitable zone of its star, as well as being twice the size of Earth. The yearly rotation is somewhat similar to our own at about 292 days. Now, temperature-wise, the planet actually isn't too bad. The best readings state that at its worst, it may only get down to 11 degrees Fahrenheit, and at its best, it'll be around 71 degrees Fahrenheit, which means the planet doesn't get immensely hot, but also not too cold. The catch, though, why is there always a catch? Is that the outer layer of the planet is believed to either be all water or all gas. It's unclear how this could affect humanity, but it is something to note. Still, this is considered one of the best Earth-like planets that we know of right now, and some are even stating that should Earth evacuate, we'd be going to it over other possible contenders. Number 1. So where does this leave us? So you've seen a bunch of planets that could sustain life and might be possible Earth-like contenders should humanity embrace the stars. However, just about every single one of them has flaws or caveats that could hurt a colonization effort. Because of that, you're likely asking, what are the chances that we find another true Earth? Well, the odds aren't impossible, but as you can see, finding a planet that suits our specific needs is actually incredibly difficult. We need a planet with a suit that can emit the right amount of heat and light for not just us, but for plants and animals. We need an atmosphere that is both there to protect us from harmful cosmic rays, but also keeps in the gases we would breathe without being toxic. Water is a must, or at the very least, somewhat easily obtained. And of course, it needs to be able to keep us going long term. That's not an easy thing to ask for. But that doesn't mean we should lose hope. Many organizations are looking for more planets to research and see if they match Earth. And they might just find one. Let's just hope we're around when that happens. Thanks for watching, everyone. Do you think that humanity will reach some of them one day? When do you think it'll be? Let us know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time on the channel.